They call it the Taj Mahal. It's picturesque, it's beautiful, until you have to come here for a murder trial.
Case 2011, CR3314, People versus Daniel DeWild.
The last time I was in this room was to make a determination whether Daniel DeWild was guilty of murder.
From the very beginning, it was clear that it was a confusing case. It was old, and that this was a murder case involving identical twins, Dan and David DeWild.
The prosecution's theory was that the two brothers conspired together to kill Daniel's wife, Heather, and kept it a secret from pretty much everybody.
It was a case that went cold in 2003. My name is Robert Weiner, Chief Deputy District Attorney, Jefferson County, Colorado, lead prosecutor on the DeWild homicide. July 24th of 2003, Heather DeWild was going over to her strange husband's house. Heather had two young children, Hannah and Jacob, and she would do anything for her kids. She was supposed to sign a check. She also went over to pick up a set of insurance cards for her children. The check was never endorsed. The cards were never picked up.
She apparently arrived at the house, and then after that, she was never seen or heard from again. So, there was no evidence that she ever left the house.
You don't have any kind of murder weapon?
Correct.
You don't have any kind of fingerprints from any suspects?
Correct.
You don't have any of Heather's blood in the house where you believed she was murdered?
Correct. There was no proverbial smoking gun to tie Daniel to Heather's murder.
During testimony, we had learned that they were watching crime shows, such like CSI and other forensic shows to figure out how to get away with murder.
We got nothing. Nobody cleans a car this good. There is no evidence.
Daniel and David would watch those shows and formulate their plan, and they certainly did not leave any forensic evidence.
12 of us coming here, we're getting along just fine.
Then once we had to dig into the evidence, things changed dramatically. Because the nature of the case was so circumstantial and there wasn't any real hard physical evidence, you spend your time trying to piece it together.
And we went backwards, we went forward, and then we started putting it up on the walls, surrounding ourselves with it.
I had no idea how the deliberations were going.
It was really difficult. People were emotional. People were getting on one another's nerves.
There's a lot of pacing. There's a lot of just nervous anxiety.
There was some crying, there was some yelling that went on.
You start thinking, okay, what are they thinking about? What are they hung up on? Why are they taking so long?
We took a poll, you know, six and six. And where do we go from there?